basically really kind of a compound target. On the surface, we have a gold-rich skarn. Underneath, as I mentioned, this continuous 1.2 kilometer mineralization. And then underneath all of that, what gives rise to the entire hydrothermal magmatic system is actually a shallow porphyry.
All right, welcome back inside our proactive newsroom. And joining me now is Alex Miskovic. He is the CEO of Terra Balcanica. And Alex, it's good to see you again. How are you?
Good morning. Thank you so much for having me again on your program.
Excited to learn a bit more of what's going on. I know you had some significant news out recently, but maybe first give everyone a little background on the company.
Sure. Terra Balcanica is a junior Canadian explorer. We've been active for the last 3 years, publicly listed on the Canadian Securities Exchange and Frankfurt Stock Exchange. We have a portfolio of properties in Bosnia and Canada. In Bosnia, we've been advancing a polymetallic project in eastern Bosnia called Viogor-Zanik, where we have conducted so far about 3,500 meters of drilling. We raised the project from the standpoint of proving that mineralization exists on two different targets. And now we're in a business of basically adding those critical tons and critical ounces on both targets, Brezani and Trumavici. Last year, we have optioned 600 square kilometers of highly prospective ground surrounding Athabasca Basin in northern Saskatchewan from our partner and optioneer, Fulcrum Metals. And we plan to commence work in Saskatchewan this summer. So active on both sides of the pond, targeting both energy metals, such as uranium, and critical metals, such as antimony, silver, and zinc.
And Bosnia is where your news came out from yesterday. You announced some strong assay results there from that Brezani target that you mentioned. So tell me a little bit about what you saw there. Pretty exciting.
For sure. No, we really are. So these news are important for three different reasons. First of all, we have intercepted what seems to be a very antimony-rich intermediate sulfidation epithermal vein that basically seems to be projecting from subsurface to surface along about 45 degree angle along what we believe is a fault. So antimony is a major component. Why do I emphasize antimony? Well, antimony as of late is really, all the vogue, all the rage. The prices have skyrocketed to about $18 US a pound because of the ban on Chinese export lately. And they're projected to go even higher. So very, very highly critically valued metal, both by Chinese and European Union. Second of all, the target that we have intercepted at about 480 meters depth is actually a continuous geophysical anomaly that goes from the place where we have sliced through it all the way to the surface for about 1,200 meters. So 1.2 kilometer continuous conductivity anomaly that we, of course, intend to now to fully explore, probably going from top down as opposed to from bottom up. It just makes more sense. Mineralization, where this thing daylights on the surface, is actually clearly visible. And that's exactly what we try to do. And then, of course, the third thing is the width of the intercept, which is three times as thick as in our other target called Trumavici. And the grade. The grade is also important. Grade is a king, as we all know. We have 400 plus grams per ton silver equivalent with about 70% contribution of antimony. So continuous geophysical target coming to surface, antimony rich, and with a wide intercept between 15 and 20 meters, which is exactly what we are going to be exploring in the future.
Yeah, and you're waiting for some more holes, and those are more shallow holes, right?
Precisely. So it's basically really kind of a compound target. Yeah. On the surface, we have a gold-rich skarn. Underneath, as I mentioned, this continuous 1.2 kilometer mineralization. And then underneath all of that, what gives rise to the entire hydrothermal magmatic system is actually a shallow porphyry. All three of which we have drilled. So yeah, there's actually upcoming news stream of about four more additional holes from the shallow gold-rich skarn on the surface at Brezhany. And of course, we have some more news coming from Bosnia, more on a strategic front, as well as I mentioned, commencement of our work in Saskatchewan sometime around April.
Yeah, it sounds like it's shaping up to be a pretty busy 2025 then. That was like a lot of work on the plan.
Yes, indeed. I mean, that's exactly when last year was a year of consolidation. We have executed a corporate rollback. We have acquired a strategic asset, namely the Fulcrum's portfolio in Saskatchewan. And then we also raised about $920,000 last year during our financing. So those kind of things took care of the house, and now we actually aim to use those funds to really advance the assets in Saskatchewan. We didn't take them just to flip them around. We wanted to actually do some work and add value to them. But of course, you know, we were always and always a European explorer, somebody who focused on Europe at the doorstep of European Union. And with asset like this, high grade, thick intercept, this is very mineable. If we can prove the continuity to the surface, this can very quickly become a mine. Let's not forget the fact that in Bosnia, Terra operates right next to an existing mine. So we have an operating mine, which actually has its flotation and crushing circuit, which is actually strategically very important for us because in case of finding a mineable deposit, we can offset our CapEx expenses by having an operation right next door.
Yes, it's going to be a very busy one for sure. Alexander, thanks so much. Great to see you again.
Thank you so much for having me on.
Yeah, good stuff. Alexander Miskovic, he's the CEO of Terra Balcanica Resources.